that one belief eliminated from your brain could change the course of your reality. Would you want that? It's not for everyone, only the brave. Those who want to own their life like the powerful leaders they were born to be. A pivotal moment can change everything. Now, here is the host of Crossroads to Awakening show, Wendy Paquette.
Hello, hello, and welcome to the Crossroads to Awakening show. I'm your host, Wendy Paquette, and I'm coming to you on this beautiful April 27th, blue, sunny sky day in Ontario, Canada. And I'm a holographic mind reprogrammer. For those of you who have never heard of me before, seen me anywhere, or worked with me, I help women stuck at a crossroads awaken to their true selves and change the world from where they stand. Because I believe as a high-frequency human, you get to see your life as a direct reflection of the programs etched into your brain that can be easily shifted when you see your truth for what it is. So if you want to access your true self, you can find me on Facebook if you put in at Crossroads to Awakening Show. So come find me. Let's play together and let's get those blocks moved out of the way. So today, I'd like to welcome you to our fourth episode from the beginning there, and it's called Money. Money, money, what's stopping you from having it all? There's so many points of view that are in the way of money and what it can create for you. And especially right now, we're in the middle, kind of like through a pandemic with COVID-19. And everybody's really seeing the effects of what money is and how it supports them and how by not creating it for yourself, you find yourself stuck and in scarcity. And by creating it for yourself, what that looks like to feel abundant and probably a lot more grateful than you can ever imagine for all the work that you've put in. But from my belief system, what I understand to be true is that we are looking at money from something outside of ourselves as a thing. It is a tool to get and have and be everything you'd like to be in the world, but when you're looking at it like it's outside of you, you've already somewhat lost where you're headed with it. So my job as a holographic reprogrammer is to take those belief systems that you have about money and transform them into something that serves you with money so that you can find that money is easily available to you everywhere you go. You can create money easily, you can make money easily, you can generate money easily, and you can receive money easily from wherever you stand. And there's a lot that goes to that. I mean, it's not just as easily as, you know, oh, show up, money, like, but show up on your table. It has a lot to do with your way of seeing who you be in the world and how you show up and how you serve others. It comes down to a why. Like, why do I want money? Why do I feel like money is important to me? And what can I do with it? And then attaching that why to creation, to manifestation, to actualization. So literally pulling money into your quantum existence with the thoughts that are in your mind. Something that's so much fun to do when you finally get it, when you realize that you are 100% responsible for everything that shows up in your world. And as a transformational leader, that is one of the distinctions of being a master leader or being a leader in this reality, is understanding that you're 100% responsible. And not only is that something that is in your leadership, it's also in creation. Knowing that we are one, and by that, not we are one as in I'm looking outside of myself at every single person, but we are one in the same. I am you, you are me. So whenever you show up with something that causes an emotional reaction to me, it's actually how I'm showing up. I'm seeing you as a being outside of myself with my physical eyes. However, your experience, whatever you are doing in your life that's causing me to notice it and to have maybe an emotional response to it, is also showing me a program that's in my mind, in my brain. And those programs aren't always fun, especially when it comes to money, because everybody wants it. Who couldn't use a little bit of money in their world, right? Or who couldn't use a lot of money in their world? For me, money is the source for generosity. Flat out generosity. The more I generate, the more I get to give, the more I get to support other people in their realities and make their dreams closer, become closer to them by showing them what's truly possible. So what I'd like to do today is I have a couple of of clients, past clients, and what I can also call friends at this point, because I know them energetically, intimately, energetically in that way, and as humans embodied on this planet with me. And they are complete powerhouses in their own reality. They are creating as they're going. They're inviting in amazing things. And what I'm going to do is share with you a bit about what it's like when I say I'm a holographic mind reprogrammer, and what I do with humans is transmute those frequencies that are called programs in your brain to something that's more serving to you. So we're going to talk to them a little bit about what the experience is when we do a session together, what it feels like maybe before when coming in, like actually acknowledging the emotions that you're experiencing when certain things show up as patterns in your life, and what it feels like to actually be on the other side of transmuting those frequencies and stepping into your power and being able to create a life like you know you can create, showing up as the powerhouse that you know you are in this reality, the earth angel that's walking, which we all are here to serve, right? The planet and the people that are on it. So why I'm talking about this today is because I see where there's a gap in communities creating these shifts moving forward by raising your frequency, and not necessarily that it doesn't exist out there, but there are billions of people on the planet. So there's a lot of room for all of us to show up and raise our frequencies together. And by the power of a quantum, we're able to do it in masses, and it happens quicker and more fun, and we all get to do it together, and it's a space we get to play in. It starts with intention. So I'm launching an academy called the Crossroads to Awakening. And sorry, Crossroads to Awakening is my show. Crossroads Academy is where we all get together in an academy and play in this frequency so that we can jump it to higher and higher levels. And how that changes your life is why I brought my friends on today, my previous clients, those who I've worked with, to share with you what it feels like to actually move into a higher frequency and access and be excited about who you truly be. So in case you'd like to know where you can find me with the Crossroads Academy, you can go to my website at wendypaquette.com. And in there, you'll find, if you scroll down to the bottom, there is a space, a form that says, let's stay connected. You can pop yourself in there. It officially launches May 1st of 2020. So you can pop in there now and you can get access to being a founding member. So first, I'm going to bring in Carrie. I had her on last show, actually. If any of you have watched last show or listened to or watched, I guess, on YouTube, last week's show, we spoke about all the super fun things that she's into with being a dimensional human being on this planet, to having access to things you've never had access to before. And so what I'd like to do is bring her on and say hello and reintroduce her. Hello, Carrie.
Hello, Wendy. How are you?
I'm amazing. I'm so happy that you're here. We're just talking about what it was like to work with me in the space of shifting this frequency. So let me bring us back into this space of what happens when we work together, or when you're in a space where the frequencies, the mind programs, can be transmuted into something that becomes source energy expressed as you. So I brought you on with me today because I know that you have a testimonial for me as far as what it's like to work with me in that space. And I wanted so bad to know what it was, but I saved it for a live experience so I could be really present to what that looks like. But how about you tell the audience a little bit about who you are, maybe how we connected, and what it was like when you chose to work with me, and what is that experience after or now, once we've done that?
Well, there is a lot to say to that, so I will try to make it as quick as I can. I am a designer, a mother, a wife. I'm all of these. I think you would call me a soccer mom. And my gifts came online probably, I don't know, 2011-ish, 2013-ish, and it has just been gung-ho from there. I mean, I've moved into this space. I have a YouTube show. I've collected this amazing tribe, and we call ourselves the metaphysical moms. And it's sort of, I live in this world of how do you live with a world, a foot in this world and a foot in, you know, the unseen. So that's just sort of the background. And I believe that when you are ready for the next step, the person that is there to help you shows up. And I've been on this journey pretty much by myself as far as, you know, just reading and teaching and working with my guides. And I was at this place where I was ready for something. And you popped into my life. I think you saw a show, you reached out, and it was just this instant yes. And I feel like my guide said, okay, cue her left stage, and on you come to my stage. On you walk. Anyway, and so you have this ability, and I would like to go to the end result, but I really need to start with how I view you work. Your gift is all the above, but you have this incredible way of seeing this program that runs within, or I'll just say with me, you could see it before I could. And it's interesting because I think things come up when they're ready and they're ready to be seen and disposed of. We have these abilities. I think we protect ourselves and we kind of take on this coding. We take on, just kind of move through life, and we put up these different ideas about ourselves, and you see these and you say, okay, wait, what about this? What about that? And you, as soon as you see it, I can feel you starting to pull that out of me, transmute it. It's like you hold it in your hand and you blow and it just goes across the wind. Like you don't need that. So one profound, profound shift that you helped me make, you basically rewrote this, was not enough, not enough. I mean, I think that we feel not enough, but we are constantly told we're not enough. And when you view life through that lens of not enough, you don't deserve. So I don't deserve to be happy. I don't deserve the money. I don't deserve the love. I don't deserve whatever, fill in the blank. And you, that was a really, really big one. And I just remember sitting in my room by myself and you were walking me through this, and I'm just sobbing, you have me hold my hand in front of my heart, and you help me transmute this, and that one took a few days to really feel, and to really feel it being pulled out, like really deep roots. And the interesting thing about your work too is that it's just gone. I mean, that vibe, that feeling, it's just gone. It's like it was never there. And it is this lightness and this airy, amazing way we approach life after that. I mean, and you kind of walk along and it's like, okay, what's next? Like, what can we do next? And I'm amazed at how opened up I am, and going to the next level. I mean, that's a whole show on its own. So, I just think what you do, I mean, you're just like this master at identifying, seeing, and you go, I mean, you're down on the DNA. I mean, like you're way down there just rewriting. And I feel like the people that work with you afterwards are these super human. Okay. I've taken a lot of your time, but I can go on and on.
No, I love this. I love that you say that because, well, first I want to know what you mean by a superhuman, but I think I'm going to save that till after the break. So let me speak into something that you said. When you first came to me, what you said, you were kind of like ready. It's almost like when the student's ready, the teacher appears kind of thing. That sort of experience. Is that what you're talking about? Yeah.
Absolutely.
That happens to a lot. I find most of the beautiful humans that I work with, they come to a crossroads, which is what this show's all about, which is what the Academy is about. They're at a crossroads where there's a choice to make. And how they know there's a choice is that they get so, like, almost, you almost feel like you want to jump out of your skin. Like you're feeling that, like, I got to do something. I got to make a choice. Something's got to change. I have to really do something right now, right? You get to that space of, I liken it to, you're at your wit's end of your wit's end, like just done. Mm-hmm. And it's that moment that you shoot off that thought, somehow I appear. And I find a lot of the beautiful humans that end up in my space that I work with have had that moment where they got there and that experience shot out of them energetically and I answer the call. And it's always the most beautiful experience and most beautiful meeting. And I really relish every single one of them. So I love that we're at this space. What we're going to do is we're headed into our first break and I'm so excited because we're just getting started. So much fun. Yeah. When we come back, we're going to talk about the word superhuman that you used, Carrie. I want to know more about what you think about that. But going into our first break, you're listening to the Crossroads to Awakening show and I can't wait to talk to you after the break.
If you could wave a magic wand and have your life be anything you wanted it to be, what would it look like? Professional dancer, CEO of a multi-million dollar earth-conscious company, a screenwriter with top billing shows, and ultimately have the boldness to move about the world without emotional blocks standing in your way, therefore having the confidence to achieve anything you put your mind to. That's what Wendy Paquette knows is possible for you. The first step is understanding why you don't believe it too, or why you do, and yet haven't created it. Put on your possibility goggles and join Wendy now, because you're at the crossroads to awakening.
Are you a subject matter expert? Are you here to share your expertise with an audience waiting to hear from you in only the way you can deliver? Are you ready to have your voice amplified across the airwaves? Inspired Choices Network has a global radio platform streaming to millions of people across the world. Professionally produced and supported by an accomplished team every step of the way, you can broadcast from anywhere in the world, knowing your voice matters, and we ensure it is delivered with ease and efficiency. Eager to hear your message, the world awaits. Contact us today to become an Inspired Choices Network radio host. Email becomeahost@inspiredchoicesnetwork.com.
This is Crossroads to Awakening radio show with your host, Wendy Paquette. To participate in the program, call in the U.S. 815-880-8255. Canada 613-800-8736 or Skype us at Inspired Choices Network. Now back to the program.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Wendy Paquette and you're listening to the Crossroads to Awakening show. And just before the break, we had my beautiful friend and person who's worked with me, I hate to say client because it seems like so clinical, Carrie, and she has just really got started in expressing what it's like to actually have those mind programs, those brain programs that are causing the crazy and the crap in your life to be transmuted through what I call the spark method for radical change. And I was saying just before that I find a lot of beautiful humans come to that crossroads in their life where they're at their wit's end of their wit's end. They just don't know what it is, that something must change and they want it to change now. And so that's when they usually show up in front of me. So you said a word that I'm really curious about. You mentioned superhuman. Now tell me, what do you mean by superhuman? Are you talking about you becoming superhuman? Or what? Tell me, I'm not even going to make any assumptions here. You tell me what you were meaning.
What do you think? We forget that we are not human. We're not. I mean, we play it for a very short period of quote time and we buy into what society and what this world tells us we're supposed to do. And I think that we plan our lives from that place and we build our lives and I have a beautiful life. But then you look around and you think, okay, there's more. And we also meet people that are super human and you wonder, how does that person do all of that? How do they radiate? What do they know that I don't know? And so once you take that governor off, once you reprogram the way you view life and the way life is supposed to be, quote, set up, then all bets are off. And you can go in any direction at one time, every direction at one time. And so that's what I mean by super human. It's getting rid of the, oh, I can't do that. Oh, I can't do that. What will so-and-so say about that? It's getting rid of all of that and just going as far as you want to go.
Yeah. And you know what? I feel the same way. Superhuman being, if you were to define a human, they would have set limitations and places they couldn't go, things they couldn't do. They would be full of judgment and areas in their life that they just felt that they weren't born to have or be. And so therefore they've already written that program by mere decision. Like, and what I've come to know for sure is that right now, especially right now, there's a frequency that we live on in the planet. We've raised ourselves to a particular point where intention, your mere intention to create something or have something or live some way in your life will show up. Now, that's a magical statement in that you can be intending all day long and not realize it. You could, because it's the mere focusing on something, right? So that is kind of the precursor to intention, is having those thoughts about something. Now, we live in a world where we're continuously stimulated by something in our surroundings. So our environment creates how we intend, and how we intend creates what actually shows up, and how long and how passionately and emotionally connected we are. So when our hearts and our brains are having that coherence, that's how quickly things can arrive. So imagine, I mean, it works both ways, and I'm sure a lot of people listening have, you know, tapped themselves into manifestation, and they wonder, like, oh, how do I manifest something, or I want to manifest something, right? How do I do that? The mere curiosity about how will bring them the possibility, like maybe there's someone on YouTube talking about the steps to how to manifest, or they'll run into someone who's talking about manifestation, or they'll find a book somewhere that talks about manifestation. So they're really, when they're curious about something, the vehicle to understanding will show up. So whether it's a book or a YouTube video or another person, you're going to see your vehicle of understanding. Once you choose one of those vehicles, if you are aware enough to see those vehicles in front of you and go, oh yeah, I was actually curious about that, and there it is right there, I can learn about that right there, and then embody and participate in that, that's the next step, right? That's the next step. Okay, so maybe your curiosity just caused you to learn about it. Maybe you're recognizing in watching these videos or reading these books that you already know that you do this.
And you're remembering.
So the acknowledgement,
right?
That, yeah, you're remembering, like, oh yeah, I actually do this already. This is something that I do regularly. Now, the magical part in that is you get to look around and go, oi, what have I been creating? Like, what's showing up in me right now? Because, yeah, how did I get here? How did I create this? Why did I create this? That's an even more fun question. Because Carrie, you look around in your world, and what does it look like? Yeah, go ahead.
Well, no, but that is the next piece, though, especially working with you, is the first piece is identifying it, looking around, I want more, do I deserve more, can I have more? And you come in and say, now, where did that can I come in? You identify that coding, that strand, but then you open all of this up, and it's like saying, okay, here's $1 billion, and you say, but what do I want to do with it? And that's where you come in also, is you look at my life and you say, okay, I'm hearing that this is where you're a little bit stuck and you don't know how to move. What if you try this? And so that is the second piece that has to be said about working with you, is then how do you structure things? How do you propel yourself? And you kind of help people say, go that way, you know, and it's like, okay. And then off you go. And so, And with me, it was the show. It's like, okay, what do I want to do? And how do I go from there? Because I want, you know, this book and this and the da 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 da. And I have no idea how to do that and run a house and have 3 kids and a husband and, you know, all the stuff that my world encompasses. And you're like, okay, we got this. So, so I am now living in the space of potential possibilities, and just creating. I create, and I create from a place of passion. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I'm Wendy.
I love that. Well, I mean, there's a difference. You've always wanted to create what you want. You've, like, it's It's always there. It's evident regularly. You see what you want. You're always desiring it. The difference is where the programs get in the way are in, they entrap you into thinking, well, I can't have that. Whatever the programs are, I can't have that. I can't be a mom, a wife, you know, a mom of three kids, a wife, run a household and support my husband and be a great neighbor and be participating in the kids' school stuff or be on committees and have a show and a life and a career and support other people and still educate myself and be curious and expand my own horizons. How could I possibly do that all at one time? Right?
Exactly.
And so,
and how dare I act?
None of
I mean,
those.
How dare I act?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, which way to go? That's where most people feel overwhelmed in their life. And then they end up giving up because they realize, like, how can I possibly do one thing? I could have, maybe I made a bad choice. I shouldn't have done X, Y, Z, whatever that is, right? Because I wouldn't be here now. And I wouldn't be feeling uncomfortable and I wouldn't be frustrated with my life because had I not chosen X, Y, Z and chosen A, B, C, maybe my life would be different. But you can never go back. Somehow this, well, there is illusion, obviously, of time, of future, present and past, but there really only is now. So going back is just a mere noticing of what choices were made and how you can make a new one now. Because everything can be changed. All the programs in your mind of what you've decided about yourself, which is also an intention in disguise, can be changed, right? Reprogrammed, opened up to, you know, every possibility that's unlimited that never was, ever was, and always is at the same time. So what I like Go ahead.
No. I think that this is so vitally important right there, that moment of regret and mm-hmm. I chose to do this and I should have done that. If we reframe that into a place of, oh, all of that is wonderful, like that, it may not feel wonderful, but I can use this as and go from here and that is not wasted. You know, that those bad decisions, quote unquote,
example.
For you, not against you.
Yeah, give me an example of what you're talking about. Yeah.
Okay, I've never said this publicly. I don't have a degree. I don't have one. I have like 125 hours. I kept changing my mind. I went back. I wasn't ready to go back to school. I was all over the place. And it took me a long time, and there were a lot of different reasons. But I held that, and I thought, oh, my gosh, had I become an architect, had I done this, had I done that, my life would be so different. And now I look at that and I say, yeah, I'm not good with the whole setup of systems. And had I done that, maybe I wouldn't end up where I am now because there is absolutely nowhere else I would rather be right now, right here. And so all of that that I regretted, I now see I did that for myself. I kept myself from doing those things. I reframed it. And so I'm not ashamed of that. It was not meant to be. Yeah. And for a reason that I didn't know yet. So that's one example.
And do you notice that what you did learn and how you did apply it was enough?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And so before we shifted your not enoughness, you would have been still punning and pining for the degree that would tell you and validate you to be enough to do what you do.
The validation. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, I don't have all the letters behind my name. Well, that's okay. You know, that's fine. Yeah. Right. Exactly.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
So
it is beautiful.
What we're saying is you can be anywhere in your life. You can have any experience. You can have created everything you've created up until now. What if none of it was wrong? What if everything was exactly the way it gets to be and every choice you ever made was never wrong? And you are exactly where you get to be when you get to be here. And you're listening to this show and this episode in particular exactly when you're supposed to be. And any other decision that was made differently before now would have taken you somewhere else. And now you know that the programs that are in your brain, the ones that told you you're not good enough, or you can't trust anyone, can't trust yourself for a decision that you made that you're angry about, or you can't do something or have something or be something, or a million different things from Sunday, that you're not lovable, that you're not beautiful, all those things. What if those programs in your brain could actually be instantly transmuted so that that program rewrites itself to be you, source, expressed as you without that program in place. That's the magic. That's the true magic.
That's the magic.
Mm-hmm. And so there's so many places to go, like so many places to go with this. So my invitation to everyone is this. Know that there's support everywhere. Know that everything you've ever chosen was never, ever wrong. And that you are exactly where you get to be right now in this moment in time in order to have the shift you've been wanting, have the shift you've been needing and desiring and praying for by merely hearing this. Like I offer sessions, just conversations to identify that whatever you're thinking about is actually shiftable, even if you think it's not. Because my version, where I was born, and I would liken it to like astrology, but on steroids, when the day that I was born, the Capricorn that I am allows me to see and read source as code. And that is how I see the programs in others' brains, is by seeing source as code. The misalignment of source and the codes that are in your physical brain, in your brain that you've decided are true but are not, those things show up for me so that I can identify them and transmute them into new code, which I source code for you, expressed as you. And that's the beauty of this. It can be with everyone. Willingness is the key. Being willing to have something different than you've had up until this moment, or being willing to see that you're that magical freaking being that showed up now, today, in this moment to hear this message and then acted on it. So we're walking into a new break. It goes so fast when I'm speaking about something I'm so incredibly passionate about. And what we're going to do, Carrie, on the way back in, we're going to just close up any last thoughts you have before we go to, like, after break. And then we're going to speak to another beautiful friend that I have. And I want to say thank you for sharing publicly your experience with me, what it's like, and that we're open for others to have this transmutation of these programs in their brains so that we can raise the frequency of the humans on the planet and everything included, including the planet too. So as we walk into our next break, I will see you on the other side.
If you could wave a magic wand and have your life be anything you wanted it to be, what would it look like? Professional dancer, CEO of a multi-million dollar earth conscious company, a screenwriter with top billing shows, and ultimately have the boldness to move about the world without emotional blocks standing in your way, therefore having the confidence to achieve anything you put your mind to. That's what Wendy Paquette knows is possible for you. The first step is understanding why you don't believe it too, or why you do, and yet haven't created it. Put on your possibility goggles and join Wendy now, because you're at the crossroads to awakening. This is Crossroads to Awakening radio show with your host, Wendy Paquette. To participate in the program, call in the U.S. 815-880-8255, Canada 613-800-8736, or Skype us at Inspired Choices Network. Now back to the program.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Wendy Paquette, and this is the Crossroads to Awakening, and we've been speaking with Carrie about all the fun things that happen when you transmute these frequencies, these programs that we work with, into source code. So just want to let you know, if anyone is interested or curious about what it's like to work with me, I am opening a community membership where we're going to be doing regular frequency shifts. I'm going to be doing them in group form inside of the community, where all these frequencies can be shifted magically in a group. So I'm going to work with one-on-one person, but in there we will have an entire audience participating at the same time, which will quantum leap the frequency shift. It's going to be so much fun, and we're going to deal with a lot of these big, huge ones, like Carrie's the not enoughness and shift that into I am enough, and I can have anything I want, and I am a beautiful human who gets to have everything I've ever wanted, dreams included. So you can go to wendypaquette.com and scroll down to the bottom where it says, let's stay connected, and put your email address in there, and I will shoot you off an email and give you an invitation into the Academy. It opens May 1st, 2020. But we are receiving beautiful humans in now to be founding members. So if you'd like to be a founding member, hop on in. Anyhow, Carrie, back to that. Any last thoughts around what your thoughts around now about working with me and what that could create in your life, or maybe what it can create in others' lives?
Well, number one, I want to say that I think that we wake up at different times, and I was astounded at how you saw things that were so deeply, deeply ingrained in me that I couldn't see. And you saw it almost immediately. And it didn't take hours and hours and weeks and months and years. You went right to it. And if we all came and we were able to shift and realize that the potential is infinite, imagine what this world could be. Imagine what it could be. I mean, that's the shift that we keep talking about and we keep hearing about. So as I'm talking with you, I'm thinking, okay, I need to get back in there. I'm joining because I need to get back in there. And what comes up for other folks, usually you'll see comes up for you too. It's in there too. It's coming up for a reason. So, yes, I highly, highly recommend, you know, just go check out her work, and it'll call to you or it won't. And if it does, jump in both feet. So that's all I have. And so I honor you and thank you so much for letting me be here.
Oh, letting you. Are you kidding? You're a blessing in my life, and I know in everyone else's life that you touch with your show, with your presence, with your family, and your beautiful, beautiful beaming light inside of you. So thank you so much for sharing that. I am completely grateful for everything that you be.
Well,
please stick around. Yes?
I will, and I called you in, by the way. Do you realize how high I must have been vibrating to call you in? So, okay, I'm handing it over, and I'm just going to listen. I'm going to try.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you, Mama. I love you.
You're welcome. So I'm going to invite now in Courtney. And let me tell you, you want to talk a powerhouse with the determination, the energetic determination to win in her life. She is a magnificent human who, goodness sakes, her transmutation of her largest block changed my life in ways too. I stand for humans. I stand for powerful humans, but there was just something about Courtney that changed my life in the same moment that she had a nice shift as well. And so I'm going to invite you in, Courtney, and tell the audience about yourself and how we came to meet and what it was like to work with me.
Well, as I start off with tears in my... can you hear me?
Yeah. Yes, I can.
Okay. Okay, perfect. As I start off with, tears in my eyes. That was so beautiful. Thank you, Wendy. I remember that moment. Like, it's so vivid and just, truly speechless. that was one heck of a block that you helped dissolve.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
So I actually stumbled. Okay. So I am in a beautiful position right now. I'm going to plug in. Let's do this.
Yeah, internet's a beautiful thing, but it has its own moments. Yeah, perfect.
Okay.
Go ahead.
My name's Courtney. I worked with Wendy now for, I guess, about 6 months. I'm a NLP, so a neurolinguistic practitioner. I am also big into yoga. I've been doing that regularly on Facebook. And I actually stumbled upon Wendy. I was looking for something to do in Windsor, and she was holding an event. It had already started, but I was intrigued because I don't even know what the event was, but I ended up going to snoop on your website and just reading your about you. There was just everything resonated with me. So you offered a call and I booked that call, and I think it was for the next day or 2 days later or something like that. And I just, there was everything inside of me that just said, nope, you got to just jump in 2 feet. This is what you've been looking for. It was being able to hold myself accountable to me. And you just completely mirrored that back to me and showed me all the spots that were, like Carrie had said, just that, those blocks that obviously I couldn't see until you brought them to my awareness.
Yeah, so do you remember what you felt like, what your world was like before we started working together?
I do and I don't. Before it was, I can't even believe it's just like five, six months ago, but it was just complete chaos. I didn't realize how out of alignment I was between what I would say, but my actions wouldn't follow suit.
So give me an example.
It was like really like subtle. Goodness, I was talking about wanting to start a business for 2 years. 2 years. And just kept saying that, you know, I was working towards it, but had no idea that, you know, the stories in my head were that I was unworthy. Who am I? I need that other, you know, credential to then step into it. That were all blocking me.
Yeah, so it's kind of like, it sounds a little bit like Carrie when she says, you know, sometimes you stop from yourself from having something because you think you need something else in order to have it. Instead of just seeing the path clearly, you're waiting to get something or have something or maybe figure it out before you actually step into it. And 2 years is a long time to talk about starting a business.
Oh, yes. But, you know, I would take, like, you know, I would, okay, I got, like, you know, a website or, you know, like the little insignificant steps that you really don't need to do to do what you want to be doing.
Yeah,
but I kept thinking everything was outside of myself.
Yeah. Yeah, I think, like, speak a little bit into that. When you finally realize that you are one, you are one with the universe, you're one with everyone and everything, and that you're 100% responsible in what shows up for you. What does it feel like when you finally, like, you had a huge shift recently? I don't know if you'd like to speak into it or not, perhaps just what the experience was up until that moment where, you know, everybody kind of gets uncomfortable in the moment that they're living into a program that's a lie. The emotional response to the lie is pretty intense. You want to talk a little bit about that?
Oh, yeah, because you don't know what you don't know until you know, you know? And the moment you brought it all together was, I kept thinking everything was outside of myself. So, you know, we all know that we're worthy, but we really don't know, I guess, neurologically that there's a disconnect there. And I just kept coming back, and it was the moment when you brought me back to the root cause of, it was me in my teens, and this little girl that just kept showing up, and the magical work that you do, you brought it to my realization that I was actually blaming and judging her like she was outside of me, like that wasn't a part of my story or who I am. And
yeah,
you did this amazing reframe
like
where it just Mm-hmm.
When you say her, you mean your little girl, the little girl that, you know, you younger, a memory from you being younger.
Correct. Yeah, it was a memory from me that I thought, like, she was separate, like it wasn't me. Like she did something bad and she deserved that, and I was blaming her and judging her for where she was at without realizing that, oh my God, like that's me. How can I do that? And then it just all of a sudden just shifted into just pure love, unconditional love, that she made the choices she made because that was her path. Like she didn't make any other choice. Like that was supposed to happen. And just the love that I have for her, for where she came, and it was just this, brought her into my heart center. And like, that's me. Like, I love my journey. I love my past. I love where I'm at. I love where I'm going. And it was just a powerful, powerful, powerful moment.
Yeah. And so what I'm hearing you say is that that moment, whatever moment you're speaking of with that little girl, that was a frequency, that was a program, something there that occurred, you decided was true, therefore wrote a program that it was true. And so you spent the rest of your life living to prove something through that program that was created back then. When I say program, I mean something you've decided that resides in your brain that you start living your reality through. And so every time something comes up that activates that program, you immediately behave in a way that must prove something about that program to be true. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
So
that
that's what changed. Yeah, I remember that moment so clearly. It was a moment of, I mean, whatever occurred when you were younger, that program was so powerful. It had like tons, I want to say millions of other little programs attached to it that ran your life, that caused you to not move forward in ways that could have changed your life. And when we shifted it, actually did. Is that true?
Oh my God, yeah. I thought it was, I kept going back to that specific moment of just, it was just pure blame and pure judgment and thinking that somehow she did, the event that she caused where she made that decision was the complete opposite. Like she didn't attract, I guess that event because she was a bad person. She attracted that event because she was love. And when you told me that, it made total sense. Like it was the experience I'm talking about is more, I guess I'll just high chunk it to abuse. So I thought for some reason that I deserved that abuse. But you had a way to show me that, no, I didn't see it was abuse at first because my frame of reference was just love. Like
yeah.
I'm at a lack for words for it because it was just so powerful.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's when you finally receive you. When sometimes there's programs that are etched into your brain that disconnect you from you, separate you from you. And as you're moving through your reality, that program can really, really mess with what occurs. Because no matter what, you keep going back to trying to prove, like trying to figure out maybe what you did wrong or why a wrong choice showed up and why that occurred. And some people say, oh yeah, I was just, you know, dealt a raw, like a crappy deck. You know what I mean? Crappy cards and a, you know, a wrong deck or whatever. That was their card and they got to live with it. But it's not actually true in that sense. We all have the opportunity to start off living our lives in a very pure way. And no matter what happens, no matter what we attracted in the moment, it can all be shifted. And it's all for the betterment of your own experience in this reality, your own experience. Everything that occurs is for you to experience, own, and grow through. It's not for someone else to experience your way of living. you can have relationships that share in those ways of living, but you're still uniquely having your own experience and your own reality. And how you see the world is unique to you in every way because of those programs. So my experience of you, Courtney, when we were having that session was 100% surrender into your source, surrender into your heart, surrender into your existence in this reality and your choice to live. It is the most beautiful thing. I think I reveled in that frequency for longer than I have a lot of other frequencies that I've shifted because it was so pure and so clean and so beautiful. And I could feel your life completely changing in that moment. And I know that I had tears, lots of them. I have a physical response to the shifts that occur in other humans when I'm working with them. And my intentions are so clean and so source driven and so source rooted that when you experienced your shift, when we shifted that for you, I know that my life shifted as well. And I'm so grateful that you were so powerful enough to stand in the shit, right? Go ahead.
Yeah, that's a beautiful way to summarize it. And I guess I could really summarize it just in, you're right, like that moment was like, I got my life back. I kept thinking, I kept giving my power up so easily without knowing, unintentionally. And in that moment, it was, I got my life back. My heart just blew wide open and I don't second guess my power and the co-creating and just moving forward.
Well, it'll be super fun to have you in the academy if you decide to play with us inside there, Courtney, because you have so much to share and so much to offer. And why I'm so excited about the academy, the Crossroads Academy, is because of humans like you and like Carrie and a slew of other beautiful clients that I've worked with, because your transformation is so profound. It's so awakening. It's so life-changing on so many levels that because we are all one, you're shifting, not only are you shifting you, you're shifting others. And so the more that we can deliberately and intentionally raise our frequency in whatever way works, and there's so many ways, but in this way in particular, it'll change your experience of your physical reality. But raising the frequency is what's occurring. Source is pure and clean and the highest frequency that you have access to in this, you know, reality that we're in. And so when we transmute frequencies, we're moving ourselves from one spot to another, much like moving parallels, jumping timelines in spaces that we're living in, and you just can't see it because it's in a blink. So I know that we don't have a whole lot of time left, and I'd love to speak more into what you're up to, and we will in future shows, Courtney. So I want to thank you so much for coming. Thank you for sharing your story. Thank you for being vulnerable, and I want to say that to you as well, Carrie. I appreciate both of you. I look forward to the changes that you make in this world and how it changes because you're in it. And I want to invite everyone to, you know, come to the Academy, hang out. There is going to be so much fun that we have in there. I am a goofball. I like to enjoy life, and higher frequencies source joy. So if you would like to step into more joy, if you'd like to transmute the frequencies that are getting in the way, and if you don't know what they are, I'm going to identify them with you. So we're going to play in this world together, and we're going to move forward. So go to wendypaquette.com, scroll to the bottom, put your name and email address, and you'll receive the invitation to join the Academy. Come play with me. Let's have some fun. And I really look forward to seeing everyone or hearing everyone on our next call next week. We are going to speak into the Academy again because we'll haven't had an opportunity to play a little bit more in there and see what group frequencies feel like. And what else?
Thank you for choosing to listen to the Crossroads to Awakening radio show. Wendy Paquette will return next Monday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 1 p.m. Central, 12 p.m. Mountain, and 11 p.m. Pacific on InspiredChoicesNetwork.com. We look forward to you joining us again. Until then, enjoy your journey, and we'll meet you at the crossroads.